Hello everyone and welcome back to Austin Belts and Motors. This is Kurt Zimmerman. Today I'm going to be walking y'all through this all new 2022 Tige Z1. The Z1 and the Z3 are backed by high demand. It's a very popular model that Tige is bringing back, and 22 will be the first start of it. As you can see, we've got this frost on frost here, ready for Christmas. It's going to come paired with this double axle trailer. Here in the front, we've got a small collapsible swinging tongue here, getting those smaller garages, and then you're going to have a spare tire with a spare tire holder as well. Got some integrated built-in nav lights here on your rub rail. It's going to come with a wet sound Bluetooth stereo system. You'll have speakers all throughout the boat and up on your tower as well. Gonna have non-skid padding all along that boatmate trailer so you don't go slipping off if you're trying to board. And here in the back you can see we've got some preserver seats as well for watching your surfer, tubers, or wakeboarders. And here in the back is where all the magic happens, guys. So you've got that convex V-hole paired with your TAPS 3T system here. And these are military grade actuators. They can withstand up to 3 tons of force. And right in the center there, you're gonna have your fresh air exhaust. What that's gonna do is push all the exhaust down through the water out past the surfer. Right below that is gonna be your center plate. This is gonna be to adjust the running attitude of the boat. So you'll have 8 positions on that, and that's gonna be on your throttle body. So you can click that down all the way to a 1. That's going to put that plate all the way down. It'll cause the bow of the boat to come down. So if you're in choppy water, you'll want to get that thing all the way down. If you bump it up to about a 4 or 5, you'll notice the bow of the boat's going to come up. All right, you've got a Transom remote here in the back as well, so you can change your music, switch to auxiliary, Bluetooth, all that good stuff. Got some cup holders here on the swim deck area you can grab to get up on the swim deck as well. And then you're going to have some small storage tubs underneath these back seats. Nice walkthrough area with your non-skid padding so you don't go messing up your interior. It's also got a step down there on that seat. And then they've made it to all these backrests can articulate into 2 different positions here. Then you're going to have more backrests that pop up here throughout the boat as well. Lift this guy up. Pop that all the way down. You can see here you've got a mirror for the ladies. This is going to be one of your biggest storage compartments here. You've got your driver's mirror in here and your prop we haven't installed just yet. You'll see you have access in here to your amps, and then you'll have a battery charger as well. So if you just plug into the top, it's kind of hard to see there, plug into the top, you'll get trickle charge to your batteries. That way you come out to use your boat next time and you'll be good to go. Tige also has a bunch of main switches, so if you're ever out there and your screen goes out on the water, you've got a ballast empty, bilge pump, a blower, and nav lights. That way you can get back to your dock safely. As I was telling you before, you've got wet sound 8-inch speakers all throughout the boat, as well as your big ones here on the tower. They've added a nice charging pad here, so you can just slap your cell phone down on there, it will begin to charge. And then you've got a 12 volt charger there and some USBs right there as well. Let's take a look at the helm here. Or first, before we do that, so here's your glove box. This is where you're going to access your battery switch. So I'm going to go ahead and flip that on. What I like to tell people, it's really great to keep your phone or wallet in here. That way, at the end of the day, you'll remember to turn off your batteries. So we've got the Incharge phone holder, so you can set your phone here as well and it's going to charge for you. Got an area you can plug in an auxiliary or get some more USB charge. Nice area for your phone or wallet. Keeps it out of the sun so it won't be overheating. And to get power to your screen, it's going to be this button right here, right next to your horn. So I'm going to show you guys a couple of the basic stuff in the screen here real quick, where we won't spend too much time on it. All right, so you'll notice as soon as the screen powers up, your blower is going to kick on automatically. That'll stay on for about 2 minutes and then it'll shut off automatically as well. Or you can come in here to your switches and hit blower off. So I like to explain these like four basic apps. You've got your cruise here. So this is how you're going to set your cruise control. You've got your ballast settings so you can see where your bags are at. And that's going to be the water you're pumping into your boat to create that hole to sink deeper so you can have bigger wakes. Switch over here to your switches. You see you've got bilge, blower, you've got a button to hit all your lights on. You get a nice lighting under here and all that interior lighting. And then you've got your navs and your anchor lights as well. So basically what I wanted to show y'all real quick was the Go Touch feature. So if you were going out there, Tige made this really, really simple for the everyday basic rider to get out there and to be able to set up their wave with no issues. So you'll just go over here to the Go Touch. You'll see you've got ski, surf, wake. We're going to hit surf, go. What that's going to do is set up our surf over on the left side of the boat, and it's going to begin to fill our ballast as well. I'm going to go ahead and stop all since we're on land here. You can see this zero off speed control has gone to orange. If I hit that, it goes back to normal. But when we're on orange, that's going to be our speed setting. So we can look down here and we see that we are going to set at 11 miles an hour. All you got to do now is get your throttle body down enough to where it reaches the 11 mile marker, and it's going to set right there for you and hold that speed until you change it. If you want to go back to manual, just hit that guy off. Now it's manual throttle control. And it's easy as that, guys. Fill your ballast, set which side you want to go surf on, and you're surfing. While they're out there, you can tune the wave as well. So you've got mellow to steep. And then, of course, your taps right here. So that's going to be that center plate I was showing y'all in the back before. If you play with that guy, you get it down to a 1 or 2. It's going to elongate the wave. So if you want a steeper wave, you'll want to get that up to about a 4 or 5 and then rock the steep over here. All right, guys. And there's a lot of great videos on YouTube that goes more into depth on the screen if you would like to watch some of those. All right, guys. So we've got two board racks on this boat, so you'll be able to hold 4 surfboards or wakeboards on the racks there, and then you're going to have additional Bimini racks. So you can hold 2 surfboards here on the top as well. And this boat is a Z1, so it's going to be 21.5 feet long with a beam of 102 inches. The fuel capacity in this guy is going to be 46 gallons, and it seats up to 14 people. As you can see, we've got it outfitted for more wet sounds here in the bow. And then you're going to get a 12 volt and some more USBs over here on your port side. All right, guys, that's pretty much going to do it today on this walkthrough of this 2022 Tige Z1. Thank you guys for stopping by today. Give me some of your time. If y'all would like to see models like this or this specific model, stop by and see us here at Austin Boats and Motors in Lakeway, Texas. Give us a call at 512-263-2811.